Hello everyone, myself Dr. Amit Maheshwari. Today we are going to discuss one of the important practical of biochemistry, that is estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method. In today's video, first we will discuss theoretical aspect related to the estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method along with the discussion of various viva question, and in the end we will see the demonstration of estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method. So please watch this video till the end, and before going in the detail, please subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. So aim of the practical is estimation of serum creatinine level in the given sample. The method is by Jaffe's method. Jaffe's method is the endpoint method. Endpoint method are type of the method where sample is kept in the incubation period for fixed period of time, and at the end of the reaction, concentration of the product which is formed or concentration of the substrate which is utilized is measured. First, some introduction regarding creatinine. Creatinine is the cyclic anhydride of creatine that is produced as the final product of decomposition of phosphocreatine. So it is the cyclic anhydride of creatine. And it is excreted in urine. Measurement of creatinine and its renal clearance are used as a diagnostic indicators of kidney function. Estimation of serum creatinine is one of the sensitive tests included in renal function test. First, we will see the formation of creatinine. So, creatine is formed from three amino acids, that is glycine, arginine and methionine. And from creatine, there is a synthesis of creatinine. So, first, guanidino group from arginine is transferred to the glycine and it leads to synthesis of guanidoacetate by the glycine amido transferase enzyme, and this particular reaction is occurring in the kidney. After that, methyl group from S-adenosyl methionine is transferred to guanidoacetate by the guanidoacetate methyl transferase enzyme, and this particular step is occurring in the liver, which leads to the synthesis of creatine. Now this creatine undergoes phosphorylation by creatine kinase enzyme, and there is a utilization of one molecule of ATP, and it leads to synthesis of creatine phosphate. Now this creatine phosphate, it is the immediate source of energy for the muscle contraction. So during the muscle contraction, the first energy is derived from the hydrolysis of ATP, and after that there will be the regeneration of ATP by the hydrolysis of creatine phosphate which is stored in the muscle. So that particular reaction is called as a Lohmann's reaction. After that, creatine phosphate is converted to its anhydride end product creatine non-enzymatically and spontaneously. This particular reaction, that is conversion of creatine to the creatine phosphate, is occurring in the muscle. So this is how creatinine, which is the anhydride end product of creatine, is synthesized from creatine. And the creatine is synthesized from three amino acids, that is glycine, arginine and methionine. And it occurs in all these three steps occur in different organs. First step is occurring in the kidney, second step is occurring in the liver, and the synthesis of creatine phosphate from the creatine is occurring in the muscle, where it serves as an immediate source of energy for the muscle contraction. So this is the conversion of creatine to creatinine, which is spontaneous and non-enzymatic reaction, and this is the conversion of creatine to the phosphocreatine, which is a Lohmann's reaction. Now, therapeutic application of creatine. So, creatine monohydrate are widely taken, particularly by athletes, as an ergogenic supplement to enhance the sport performance. And creatine supplements are also taken by the patient suffering from gyrate atrophy, muscular dystrophy, and various neurodegenerative diseases. So that is the therapeutic application related to the creatine. The one important thing is creatine monohydrate are widely taken by athletes to improve their sport performance. Now, principle of estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method. So, creatine present in the serum directly reacts with the picric acid in alkaline medium to form an orange color complex of creatine picrate. Remember, the medium of reaction is alkaline medium and it leads to the formation of orange color complex of creatine picrate. The intensity of color is measured colorimetrically at 520 nanometer wavelength. So that is the principle of Jaffe's method. Now, reagents required for the estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method is, first we require saturated picric acid solution, then sulfuric acid, then 0.75 normal NaOH, then creatinine standard, and sodium tungstate. So these are the various reagents required for the estimation of serum creatinine. Then preparation of protein free filtrate. So protein free filtrate can be prepared in centrifuge tube. Take 1 ml of distilled water, 1 ml of serum and 1 ml of sodium tungstate and add 1 ml of sulfuric acid in it. And after centrifugation, use the supernatant as a protein free filtrate. This is how you can prepare the protein free filtrate, but for the UG and DMLT practical, this protein free filtrate are given directly, so student doesn't have to prepare this protein free filtrate. Now procedure. So take three test tubes and mark them as a blank standard and test and proceed as follow. In the blank, take 5 ml of distilled water, and in the standard, take 5 ml of creatinine standard, and in the test, take 5 ml of protein free filtrate as a test. And in all the three test tubes, add picric acid 2 ml. So, to add 2 ml of picric acid in all the three test tubes, that is blank, standard, and test, and then add 0.5 ml of 0.75 normal NaOH in blank, standard, and test. Mix thoroughly and keep at room temperature for 10 minutes. And after that, read colorimetrically at 520 nanometer wavelength or at clean filter. So that is the operational procedure related to the estimation of serum creatinine. Now, observation table. After reading the optical density, put the optical density of blank, standard, and test in the operational observation table. And then do the calculation. So the formula for the estimation of serum creatinine is optical density of test minus optical density of blank divided by optical density of standard minus optical density of blank multiplied by concentration of standard multiplied by volume of standard multiplied by 100 divided by volume of serum. So the concentration of standard is 0.003 and the volume of standard is 5 multiplied by 100 divided by volume of serum is 0.5. So ultimately it leads to optical density of test minus optical density of blank divided by optical density of standard minus optical density of blank multiplied by 3. So after reading the value in this particular formula, you will get the creatinine value in milligram per deciliter. Now, what are the various limitations of Jaffe's test? So Jaffe's reaction is less specific. Only 80% of the color which is developed at the end of the reaction is due to the creatinine in the serum. In the serum, there are presence of other substances like glucose, urea, uric acid, and protein, which will react with the alkaline picrate and contribute to the color development and giving rise to the higher results. That is the one of the limitation of Jaffe's test. In the serum, there is a presence of glucose, urea, uric acid, and protein, which will react with the alkaline picrate and it will contribute to the color development and it will give the higher results. true creatinine value can be determined by getting rid of this non-specific chromogen by the use of Lloyd's reagent, which is hydrated aluminium silicate. So by the use of Lloyd's reagent, we can measure the true creatinine value. So this Lloyd's reagent will adsorb creatinine in acidic solutions, and after centrifugation, the pellet is resuspended in alkaline medium to elute creatinine, which is then estimated. So this is how you can overcome the limitation of Jaffe's test by Lloyd's reagent, and it is one of the important Viva question. Now, other method is also available for the estimation of serum creatinine, that is enzymatic method. In the enzymatic method, there is a use of various enzymes like creatininase, creatine kinase, pyruvate kinase, and lactate dehydrogenase. So first, creatininase will convert creatinine to the creatine, and then this creatine will be converted to the creatine phosphate by creatine kinase, and ADP, which is formed at the end of this reaction, will combine with the phosphoenol pyruvate, and in the presence of pyruvate kinase, this phosphoenol pyruvate will be converted to the pyruvate. And this pyruvate, with the help of lactate dehydrogenase enzyme, is converted to the lactate, and there is a synthesis of NAD+. And we have to measure the concentration of this NAD+ in the enzymatic method. So this is the principle of enzymatic method. So by enzymatic method, we can measure the serum creatinine, and it is more sensitive and specific as compared to the Jaffe's method. Now, normal range of serum creatinine. So the reference range of serum creatinine for the males are 0.7 to 1.4 milligram per deciliter, and for the females it is 0.4 to 1.2 milligram per deciliter. The concentration of serum creatinine in the male is higher as compared to the female, because the level of serum creatinine is depend on the muscle mass. So in the male, muscle mass is more as compared to the females. Now, interpretation of value of serum creatinine. So serum creatinine level will be increased in various causes. So first we will discuss the pre-renal causes. So pre-renal causes are congestive heart failure, shock, diarrhea, uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, use of diuretics. And the renal, in the congestive heart failure, shock and diarrhea, it will lead to the decrease in cardiac output and blood volume, and ultimately this will result in the decrease in GFR, and the decrease in GFR will lead to the decreased clearance of creatinine, and ultimately it will result in the increased creatinine in the blood. So this is the mechanism how there is an increased level of serum creatinine is found in congestive heart failure, shock and diarrhea. The renal causes for the increased level of serum creatinine is damage to the glomeruli. The post-renal causes are prostatic hypertrophy, calculi blocking the ureters, neoplasm compressing the ureter. So these are the post-renal causes. This is the picture showing the condition causing increased blood creatinine and condition causing increased urine creatinine that we have already discussed. There is high blood pressure, diabetes, hyperthyroidism, dehydration, muscle conditions like muscular dystrophy, myasthenia gravis, acromegaly. So this all conditions leads to increase in the blood creatinine. And this is the picture showing the conditions which leads to decreased in the blood creatinine. So the decrease in the blood creatinine can occur in debilitation due to the increased age or decreased muscle mass, and in the pregnancy, and various other regions which will lead to the decreased urinary creatinine are kidney damage due to the severe infection, shock, cancer, vegetarian diets. So these are the various causes for decreased in the creatinine value. Now, creatinine clearance. It is a test which indicates renal function, and in the sample we have to take 24 hours urine sample and serum sample. Procedure for the creatinine clearance is, first serum creatinine is measured, then total volume of urine output and urinary creatinine is measured, and then it is calculated by using the formula, that is, clearance is equal to U multiply by V divided by P, where U is urinary creatinine, V is rate of urine flow, that is milli ml per minute, and the P is the serum concentration, that is milligram per deciliter. So after the measuring the various value, you have to feed those value in this formula, that is clearance is equal to UV divided by P. The normal range for the creatinine clearance is, reference range for the urinary creatinine is 1 to 3 gram per 24 hours. And the creatinine clearance in the male normal range is 85 to 125 ml per minute. And in the female, it is 80 to 115 ml per minute. Now, creatinine coefficient. It is another important Viva question. The sum of the milligrams of creatinine and creatine nitrogen excreted per kilogram of body weight is termed as a creatinine coefficient. And the normal value for the creatinine coefficient in the man is 7 to 10 milligram per kg, and in the female it is 5 to 8 milligram per kg. Now, various Viva questions. What is creatinine and what are the indications for its measurement? So we have already discussed that creatinine is the anhydride end product which is produced from the creatine, and it is done for the assessment of the renal function. Why is creatinine estimation considered as a better indicator than urea estimation to assess the kidney function? So creatinine is better as compared to the urea for the estimation to assess the kidney function, because creatinine value is depend on the glomerular filtration. It is, the creatinine value is not affected by the tubular reabsorption or secretion, and it is also not affected by the protein diet. So that's why creatinine is better than urea. What is the difference between creatine and creatinine? We have already discussed in the beginning of the video. What is the clinical significance of estimating serum creatinine level? We have already discussed this part as well. What is creatinine clearance? That is also we have discussed, that creatinine clearance value is measured by creatinine clearance equal to the urinary concentration multiplied by volume of urine divided by the plasma concentration, and it is the test done for the assessment of renal function. In which conditions creatinine level will be increased? So there are the pre-renal, renal and post-renal conditions that we have already discussed. What are the methods for the estimation of creatinine? So there are the two methods. One is the Jaffe's method and another is the enzymatic method. So these are the various questions that will be frequently, which are the frequently asked in a Viva and practical. Now let's see the demonstration on estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method on calorimeter.
So we have already seen the theoretical part of estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method. Now we will see the demonstration how to do the estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method on the calorimeter. So the first step is you have to take the three test tube and label them as blank, standard and test. So this is the first step. After the completion of the first step, then you have to take the 5 ml of distilled water with the help of pipette controller in the blank test tube. So you have to add the 5 ml of distilled water in the blank test tube. So this is the instrument which is called as a pipette controller. If you are not having this instrument, then you can also do the mouth pipetting. So this we have already added 5 ml of distilled water in the blank test tube. Now you have to add the 5 ml of creatinine standard in the standard test tube. So value of creatinine standard is already known, which is 3 mg per deciliter. So you have to add this 5 ml of standard in the standard test tube. And then you have to add the 5 ml of protein free filtrate. Protein free filtrate in the test tube. So this is the way you have to collect the protein free filtrate with the help of pipette controller. and you have to add in test tube. After the addition of this blank standard and test, then the third step is you have to add 2 ml of this picric acid, 2 ml of this picric acid solution in the blank standard and test tube. So this is the bottle dispenser. With the help of bottle dispenser, you have to add blank standard and test, 2 ml of picric acid solution in all the three test tube. So that is standard and 2 ml of picric acid solution in the test tube. Fine, and then you have to add 0.5 ml of 0.75 normal NaOH in all this three test tube. So 0.5 ml or 500 microliter of 0.75 normal NaOH in all the three test tube, that is blank, standard and test. After the addition of this NaOH in all these three test tube, you have to mix it thoroughly and you have to keep it in the room temperature for 5 to 10 minutes, and after the incubation period is over, then you have to take the optical density in the colorimeter at 520 nanometer. You have to take the optical density at 520 nanometer wavelength. So after the addition, you have to mix it thoroughly and then you have to keep it at the room temperature for 5 to 10 minutes. So this is after 5 minutes of incubation period. As you can see, there is a change in the color of standard and test. We have already seen the principle of Jaffe's method, in that it was in the alkaline medium, creatinine reacts with the picric acid and it forms orange colored complex creatine picrate. So as you can see, in the standard and test tube, there is a orange color is already formed. In the standard, orange color is quite darker as compared to the test. Now we will take the optical density of the blank standard and test on the colorimeter at 520 nanometer. Fine, so first we will set the zero in the colorimetry by giving the water blank. So we are setting the zero in the colorimetry. So zero has been set. Now we will take the optical density of the blank standard and test. So first you have to transfer the blank in the flat bottom test tube. You have to wipe out the test tube and then you have to take the optical density. So this is the optical density of the blank. After the optical density of the blank, you have to take the optical density of the standard. So this is the optical density of the standard. After that, you have to take the optical density of the test. So this is the optical density of the test. After the optical density of the blank standard and test, you have to feed this optical density in the formula and then you will get the value of the serum creatinine. So this is all about how you can do the estimation of serum creatinine by Jaffe's method on the colorimeter. Thank you for watching. Thank you.